Well, guys, let me go ahead and move on to the final topic of the day, man. The one that most people are probably excited about and sad about too. But yeah, this is the final topic of the day. Looks like we have an update for Black Panther 2. Lupita Nyong'o had a sit down with Yahoo Entertainment, and they got this exclusive interview. Let me go ahead and bring up the article right here. But the main thing that this is focusing on is how she feels about Black Panther and how that's been handled by Ryan Coogler. And she says that Nyong'o will soon return to Wakanda, actually Atlanta, to begin production on Black Panther 2, which is once again being directed by Ryan Coogler, but it will be the heaviest of hearts, having lost Chadwick Boseman, who played Marvel's African King T'Challa and died last August of colon cancer. And just real quick, are you excited about going back? Excitement isn't the word. I feel like I'm in a very pensive and meditative state when it comes to Black Panther 2. His passing is still extremely raw for me, Nyong'o says before her voice starts to crack. And I can't even begin to imagine what it would be like to step on set and not have him there. But at the same time, we have a leader in Ryan who feels very much like we do, who feels the very loss in a very, very real way as well. And his idea, the way which he reshaped the second movie, is so respectful of the loss we've all experienced and a cast as the world, excuse me. So it feels spiritually and emotionally correct to do this. And hopefully what I do look forward to is getting back together and honoring what he started with us and holding his light through it, because he left us a lot of light, that is. And I have my feelings on this, and I'll be happy to give them. But Larry, I'm coming to you first. We've talked about recast T'Challa before and whether they should or not, and just, you know, how the production of Black Panther should proceed. How are you feeling about her comments with her saying that, you know, the way Ryan Coogler is handling it feels spiritually and emotionally correct?
Yeah, I want to know what she means by that, because she said it was very respectful for their loss. And I'm like, damn, that sounds like they're not going to put him in the movie. They're not going to put T'Challa in the movie. And I'm thinking, this just frustrates me to no end, right? Because I'm like, look, I understand that Chadwick died. We all loved him as an actor. He was fantastic. But this is show business. And show business is a business, you know? I mean, did Apple stop making phones because Steve Jobs died? You know, I mean, you keep on pushing forward. You keep on delivering the product because that is what you do. It is a business. And if they don't recast him, if they don't move forward with this, it's going to be a horrific lose a lot of fans. And I think the Black Panther, franchise, or part of the franchise, is gonna dwindle. I think that I don't completely die, but I don't think people are gonna be as enthusiastic for it if they kill off T'Challa, because so many stories within the whole Wakanda world is dependent upon T'Challa. You know,
correct. I agree.
The only thing other that they could do is just bring forward Killmonger to his rightful place, but they're not gonna do that. So.
You was doing so well, man.
I knew it was coming.
But I mean, honestly, I get why they're feeling the way they feel. They all work together. I can imagine if you work with someone, and these projects are not something where you just somebody writes it and then just say, okay, we're going to cast you, and then 3 months later the movie's done. I mean, these projects take years, you know? Mm-hmm. I mean, they take years and years and years where people writing scripts and rewriting scripts and going through pitch meetings and finding financing and going through all the, you know, all the table reads and everything else that goes along with it before you even finally hit the set. And then you have all the other stuff, all the people traveling together, promoting the movie and all the Comic-Con crap they do and all the talk shows that people do together. And I mean, I get it. There's a lot of stuff that you do with these people. You get very, very close to them. I understand why everybody's in their feelings, but as it is with anybody else, when someone passes away, you have to keep living your life.
Right.
It sounds cold-blooded, but it is what it is, man. It is what it is.
Let me grab this. We want the representation, period. I agree, Lizzie Latrice. And let me grab this real quick.
What a money reside. What a money reside. What a money reside. What a money reside. Okay.
Wakanda Forever, $10 super chat. I wanted them to recast King T'Challa, but I'm glad they will honor Chadwick Boseman. In a few years, they can bring back Black Panther in the MCU. I'm excited for the Ryan Coogler Disney Plus series. Thank you so
here's
much.
Here's the thing.
Hold on. Thank you so much, Wakanda Forever. I really do appreciate the super chat. Thank you. Go ahead.
I was going to say, by the time they bring back Black Panther 2, it will have been a few years. It's already been a few years. We're talking about 2021 right now. The movie came out, what, 2018, 2019? Mm-hmm. It's already been a couple years. It's not come. The next one's not supposed to come out until 2022, and that's assuming that it comes out on time. I mean, it will have been a number of years by the time we get the new Black Panther. So, I mean, there's no reason not to cast him.
One take?
Yeah, I'm still, this is like so tricky because, but what she's saying, like they're going to honor him, that doesn't really give you any like indication as to what's actually going on. Like we kind of still like left in the loop and we won't know until like the movie actually comes out what they decided to do with his character in the movie, which is like, I think a lot of us, I think well, most of us on this panel pretty much are like, we don't want you to kill this character off screen and then like have it put in the movie. Like we don't feel like that's doing the character justice. Like we like basically recap. My whole thing, my stand on it has been the same. I always felt like, hey, push the movie back, do the series, introduce him in the series, and then make the movie. Because I like that. Yeah. I have tons of faith in Ryan Coogler. Ryan Coogler has delivered me a movie I didn't like. It's just this is a very different situation. And so us not knowing and if they're just like standing on that whole set, they're like, hey, they're not recasting T'Challa. I don't think the results are gonna be good once we actually see the final product. As much as I love Ryan Coogler.
I agree, my brother. Elliot.
Yeah, man, this is, Larry and One Take said it well, man. I mean, this is a tough situation. I mean, to know that this film is coming out in a year and 2 months from now, like, One Take, I don't think that's possible. To know that they restructured the whole film, they rewrote the whole film, and as you just said, spiritually, you know, kind of having his influence in the film, I think it's just better for them to delay it, have the show first. I don't know if they'll reintroduce him on a TV platform just because I think they do want to save some things for the big screen, some characters for the big screen, and introducing a new T'Challa would be more of a big screen type of event versus a TV type of event, but who knows? But in regards to her comments, when she said spiritually, the only thing I thought of is I would hate for them to do this, but I think they're going to, if they do kill the character off, they're going to have him be like the new Black Panther god. And spiritually speaking, he's going to be, I think it's the Black Panther god is Bask, if I'm not mistaken. Mm-hmm. I think they might do something that to honor him, that he is like the god of the Black Panthers, to still have his influence on other Black Panthers to come ahead and the mantle and being on the ancestral plane of some sort. So when she said that was the only thing that kind of came to mind, because I really don't know what else they're going to do besides the whole, I guess the synopsis that's out there now floating on the internet is that they're going to, especially with the shows, they want to explore other aspects of Wakanda. So if I were to assume a Black Panther 2, Shuri, Okoye, Nakia, and Adora Milaje doing some side missions maybe outside of Wakanda, and then a Black Panther 3 brings it back to Wakanda because they're under attack by Doom or Namor, whatever the case may be. So I'm thinking that Black Panther 2 is going to be a more of a global film of them going outside of Wakanda, which would be crazy, but I think that's where they're going to be headed. And I wouldn't be surprised if those rewrites that that Ryan is doing now involve Sam Raimi, involves Spider-Man 3, involves Loki. They might do some things that Wakanda was interfered by the multiverse, because with the blimp and everything that happened in Endgame, we got to remember that for 5 years, there was no king. There was no T'Challa on Wakanda. So what was going on in Wakanda for 5 years? So I think that they might put Wakanda off for a series, and Black Panther 2 is going to be outside of Wakanda for a film, again, whatever that storyline looks like. So I've Nate Moore, Kevin Feige, Ryan Reynolds, and the cast and crew is not an easy task. If I'm Disney right now, who am I more okay with not being okay with the result? Am I okay with the recast, you know, having not to recast the character and how that audience is going to be? Are they going to come to see the film? Are they going to go watch the show? Or do I want to, you know, make the people that are okay with T'Challa not being recast? So I think right now they're picking, you know, whatever one makes more financial sense. They're going to go that route, but We'll see, man. This is a tough call. It's a tough call for sure.
Now think about this.
Hold on.
What a money reside. What a money reside. What a money reside. What a money reside.
I'm gonna give my two cents real quick, because I have an idea of how it can work. So I thought you were gonna allude to it, but we don't know what happened in that 5 years. And I feel that what she's saying feels spiritually and emotionally correct, how they can't pay respect. I think it can work a way that everybody loves it. During that 5 years, T'Challa was blipped, he was gone. So, what if the Black Panther 2 movie takes place during those 5 years? It picks up right after the blip or whatever, and all of Wakanda is like, damn, we just lost our king. He was snapped away by Thanos, and so in the movie they're going to pay tribute to their king because they actually lost their king in the story in the MCU, but also in real life. So it kind of like has double meaning. You're paying respect to him in the movie because you actually did lose him in the movie. And you lost them in real life. And so that would fit to me. That would make perfect sense. And it also gives them time to develop the Wakanda show or shows and also recast. I think that's seamless. But, you know, how you feel about that?
To that point, I would actually say a series. I would actually probably want to explore that more in a series more so than a movie. But that is a good idea. If just that concept alone to me sounds interesting. But I think that would be more of a really interesting TV show to explore the Wakanda during the blip. But
the whole thing with that though, Shuri was actually blipped away as well though.
Right.
So,
was she?
Yeah, she was. Shuri was blipped away during the blip as well.
Well, that's cool. They can. I mean, hey, I think it would still work. But Larry, go ahead. You was gonna say something as well.
Well, I was just gonna say. I mean, I think that would be a great way to end the series and lead into the Black Panther 2 if they could do it. Is to basically have, at the very end of the series, have T'Challa come back from wherever he's gone. Maybe he was gone in the multiverse, or he's gone in the, you know, because of the blip or whatever. But he comes back, and all we see is him from the back. And somebody say, you know, maybe you see the Dora Milaje. All of a sudden, all you see them is take a knee, you know, or snap to an attention or something. You see him come in on the screen, and then you see his, you know, his Black Panther, you know, helmet just sort of come down. And we see hair, but we don't actually get to see who it is because it's from the back, and we don't get the reveal of who it is until the movie. Because then we get to see T'Challa's back, but we don't know who he is. We don't know which, you know, as the actor, we don't know who it is. We just know that he's back. And that gives them time to recast. It gets to bring him back into the world.
You don't have to show his face. He could be in a suit.
Do y'all think they could have possibly, I mean, you know, Marvel keeps a lot of things under wraps. Do you think they could have possibly already casted up T'Challa?
I think it's possible. Might have. I hope so. And I think that if they do end up recasting, they can easily explain in the story of why he looks different, because we do have the multiverse and thing. I mean, like when we look at the Loki trailers, we see the timelines converging and like, you know, mountain, like it's falling apart, like worlds are folding on top of worlds. It's kind of like the Matrix Reloaded to Revolutions or whatever. The Oracle, she looked different or whatever, you know, and you can explain it that way. So hopefully do you guys
remember who was in the running for Black Panther back before they cast it Chadwick in 2014 with Civil War? Do you guys remember any of the names that were circulating during that time?
Do you?
No, because I was just thinking, because I know Loki was initially, he tried out for Thor, but obviously he became Loki, and I believe Wyatt Russell auditioned to play Captain America, so they brought him back into the fold. So Marvel has this thing where they like to bring in people that they may have never casted in the initial roles to bring them back in the forefront. So I wonder who were those actors that were final three, top five casting choices. They might, you know, reach out to that person that didn't get that opportunity.
Right on.
What a money reside. What a money reside. What a money reside. What a money reside. Okay, I'll tell you.
Jonathan Soul, 499 Super Chat. Hollywood establishment does not want to recast T'Challa because it was a stronger positive Black male image than they anticipated. You know, Jonathan Soul, if I had to put on my 10-fold feet right now, I wouldn't say he was wrong, but at the same time,
I don't even think you need to put on your 10-fold hat for that one. I think it could just be the case.
Yeah, it's not impossible, man.
I'll play devil's advocate to that comment because it made so much money. Why would Hollywood, regardless of the political racism and all the stuff that goes on in Hollywood, that would be kind of silly to not disrespect Chadwick Boseman, but going back to Larry saying the money's there. Why would you not take the opportunity to recast this character that brought so much to the box office?
That is true. It is true. However, the U.S. Bank did come out with a report saying that the U.S. has wasted like $16 trillion on racism, white supremacists to uphold it. The crazy thing about it is that's close to the amount that's owed to us, the debt that is owed to Black Americans. So you have a good point, Elliot, but at the same time, the system of white supremacy will blow their own foot off to make sure that they stay above the economic ladder above
us.
I don't know, man. It's an ugly situation. It's hard to decide what to do because you can't please everybody. Hopefully, I just want them to take their time, man. If they came out tomorrow and was like, look, we still don't know what to do, we're gonna holler at y'all in a year, I wouldn't trip because you got so many other properties. I would not trip. I would be like, take your time, get it right. So
here's the thing about recasting, I think, is that you just do it. And then there are some people that will never accept someone being a character being recast. And there are other people that are open and willing and want to see it and will accept anybody. And then there's those that are just like, okay, this person has to be good. And I think you just have to just put somebody in there and just do it. I mean, we see this all the time with every 10 years or 12 years or something, we get a new James Bond. It's probably more than that, but just in my lifetime, we've had four different Bonds, something like that, five different Bonds. We see it all the time. Different Batmans, you said different Jokers, and we just have to, do it. And then people accept it.
Yeah.
I'll say this too, to that point, obviously hashtag recast T'Challa. To be honest, in Hollywood, again, how influential Chadwick Boseman was, if I'm a young upcoming actor, yes, that's a great opportunity, but that's a lot. Those are big shoes to fill. So I wonder if there's some actors out there that are just maybe scared to even take on that role, and just that, just the level of criticism comparing him to Chadwick Boseman, not living up to that legacy. It's easy to say to recast it, but if I'm, a young upcoming actor, that can be a role that can either make or break their career. So it's a tough call to make.
The actor you don't want in that role. Right. You want that actor that's confident, that says, yes, I can handle this. That's the dude you want in that role.
Good point. And I'm so ready to shut all of that noise down. If anybody tries to compare them,
that's coming.
I got the block button ready. I'm not going to have it. That's just disrespectful. You know what I'm saying? You don't know. You're gonna compare. Well, I think he was better. Shut up. I don't want to hear your opinion on that, man. It's like,
but Brandon, I feel you, but it's a little unfair because we do it all the time. We just did it last night on your show when we were comparing Mortal Kombat dudes from the second one to the third.
Different because nobody died. This has to do with a death.
They compare the Supermans, Henry Cavill to Christopher Reeves and all that all the time.
They may not be comparing the people themselves, they're comparing the characters. Who did the character better?
Right.
And those comparisons are going to be made regardless.
Well, they're not going to be made here. You're right, but I don't mean to sound snappy, but I'm just saying, like, I wouldn't do that because the guy died. You know what I'm saying? Like, nobody. Yeah. Nope, and Christopher Reeve, he passed in the 70s. Well, I don't remember exactly when he passed.
I think he passed like the 90s. Yeah.
Yeah.
So but he wasn't even in the role anymore. I mean, this guy is at the very beginning of his career. I think that would just be so insensitive to try to do that. Yeah, we're gonna have our trolls, and we got stupid people making death threats. All that stuff. But we was talking about the Wyatt Russell. Mm-hmm. So we gotta purge that toxicity offline. You know what I'm saying? And let me grab. I almost forgot to grab this.
What a money reside. What a money reside. What a money reside. What a money reside. Okay, I'll tell you.
Oh, Cam's Truth and Wisdom, $4.99 super chat. Hold up, but y'all are forgetting. T'Challa came back, reappeared in Endgame. Yes, but I don't understand the reference.
I think they were saying he can come back and, like, you know, like Larry was saying, he take off like the helmet and like just show the back of him. He's saying that he already came back in the Endgame.
Gotcha.
And I just want to point out to some people in the comment section saying that the Black Panther mantle lives, or M'Baku can be Black Panther. It's not about Black Panther. It's about T'Challa.
The stories
that go on are about things that T'Challa does specifically. It's not just about the Black Panther or the mantle of Black Panther. And to Elliot's point, I don't really want to see T'Challa. I don't want to see T'Challa's Black Panther become the next Bask or whatever, because I think when someone becomes a god, they're like, they have to be really pure and good, and not that we and T'Challa was desperately flawed in a lot of the comics. He was constantly making bad decisions. He made good ones too, but he was constantly making bad decisions. And people often overlook the fact that of Wakanda, they always, because we always look at it as this utopia. Wakanda was in constant conflict. There was always somebody trying to take over Wakanda from either the inside or the out, or from out. It was in constant conflict. And there were times where T'Challa was off fighting with the Avengers and had to come back, back home to defend his kingdom. So,
this dude right here is rich. I like this son in the movie Fences as the next Black Panther. Hey, I mean, you know, I just want them to recast. And thank you so much for the super chat. And I'll just go ahead and say this too, hopping off Larry. As far as, and I almost lost my train of thought. I forgot what I was about to say. Oh, yeah, the mantle. Yes. The T'Challa, we want to see that story. And like, I remember somebody shared a Shadow and Act article about them covering this. There was a young lady, it was about E-Man and his petition. And her comment was just like, the people that made this petition just don't want to see a Black girl, Shuri, become a Black Panther, period, exclamation point. And it's like, that is just so ridiculous. Like, I just want to go ahead and clearly say this to just shut out the noise. Do I want to see Shuri take on the mantle of Black Panther? Yes. Will I be disappointed if she won't take on the role of Black Panther? Yes. However, I want both. I want as many stories with T'Challa doing Black Panther and Shuri and M'Baku and whoever. And so I don't want to hear any fake crap talking about we don't want to see women in a superior role, anything like that. That's ridiculous. I'm shutting that down right here. And so
you can have more than one Black Panther at a time. We had it in Civil War. We had it in Black Panther. I mean, King T'Chaka and T'Challa were both Black Panthers at the same time. They both had the herb in them, you know?
Going back to that whole pushing it back, I'm still confused on why they haven't pushed it back other than meeting a deadline. Because I'm just, when James Gunn was fired for Disney for 8 months and they came back, they delayed that film almost 2 years for the director being fired and rehired. I don't know why they can't push this film back a year or two for a big death. Like, I'm still confused on why they have to hit this deadline. I know Marvel has their stories that they want to follow and everything connects to this, but I'm still so confused on why they just can't push this back a year.
I agree, man. Lukana never $3 super sticker. Thank you so much. I really do appreciate it. And that's all. Go ahead, Larry.
I was gonna say, someone in the comment section said that they thought that Damson Idris would be good in this role. And I do think that if they recast, and I hope they do, I hope they pick someone young. I think it should be someone young like him. Because we do want someone that can grow with this role. I mean, when you look at the time frames of these movies, of the movies that come out, I mean, look when what's his name? Dude from Iron Man, we're talking about what, like a 17 year stretch or something like that. I mean, you need somebody that's gonna be young so that as the time progresses, they don't, you know, around you look like, oh damn, the dude's 62 years old. I mean, that's part of the issue that you have with Wolverine. The dude's not supposed to age, except he's aging because that's what humans do. But he's been in there for a while, so they got their money out of him. But you need to start young. You can't go with somebody who's already, you know, 39, 40 years old, and then you think you're going to have him for 20 years. It's not going to work. You need to find some young cat that's going to be like 26, 27, and that can grow with the role.
Right on. I got a little surprise I'm going to ask y'all about. Any other comments about this before I move on to close everything out?
One thing I'll say, if they do keep that release date, we will be finding out what they're going to do in probably in the coming months, because this is going to be a year that it'll come out. So I would imagine subtitle, if it is recast, in the synopsis. So we'll be learning what they're going to be doing in the coming months.
Right on, right on, right on.